You can see the week one introductions. Am I right?
Yes.
Very good. Okay, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and Ahmaduhu wa nusalli ala Rasulihi al-Kareem, amma ba'd. So this is week one, and we are going to talk about the introduction to sustainable development. And this is what actually this course wants you to have it. So the basically this is what are the objectives of this course. Why we are actually teaching this? Because we want our students to increase their knowledge on the concept of sustainability, so that they can actually develop the right attitudes, they can understand their values, they can have some sort of skills when it comes to address the sustainable development issues, because sustainable development issues are everywhere. And and it is globally available. It is also locally available. Sometimes you won't realize that it is actually locally available, because it seems like locally everything is good. It seems like everything is green, everything is enough. So why should I worry about it? When there is a fire and keep on spreading in your street, you won't be sitting in your house. You will come outside, and you will monitor, and you will make sure that the fire will not reach your house. You won't say that, no, the fire is there, why should I worry about it, right? You won't say that. So the same thing, the similar examples, the metaphor that I can give to everyone, that we cannot simply say that, okay, I don't have the problem, so why should I worry about the sustainable development. The thing that the world, the way the world is going, moving fast, it can actually affect, it can actually give an impact to every single one of us. That's why this challenge is actually encountering in the globalized world. And then today, our world is actually connected. Connected, I mean, what I mean by that, it has been connected more than you can imagine. It's in your single palm. It's actually everything, because one thing goes, one thing comes. You can see that if the world market going down, everything will go down. If the US dollar is going down, everything goes down. If the petrol price goes up, everything goes up. This is what actually today's world. It is all interconnected so much. We cannot simply run our own economy without looking into our neighbor's country, because it is not possible anymore. So everything, every single thing is connected. Today, the way that we go, the way that we live, the way that we think, it is all simply connected. It is not possible to be separate ourselves. That's why the challenges are still there, and the students, they have to increase their knowledge on this concept of sustainability. Later, I will be telling you what exactly the definition of sustainability, but for now, you need to understand it is very important to learn. Yeah, more specifically, this course aims to demonstrate the importance of sustainable development principles and practices, and will also include Islamic perspective on sustainable development. So this is not actually the knowledge for this course. This is not actually the knowledge for this semester. This is not actually the knowledge for your degree. This is the knowledge for your life, your entire life, not your only your life, your upcoming descendants' life, your children, your great 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 grandchildren, and all of their life. Because it depends on how do we use the resources, so that we can keep those resources, so that tomorrow future generation can meet, can have it. So that this is what actually kind of we need to understand the sustainability. We need to know that what are the problems are today we are facing, and how these problems can expand tomorrow, and how these problems can hurt us. There are problems, of course, but Is that problem really matter to you? That's the question always comes, you know, because you just imagine if you remember, I hope so, because you are not, you're all Alhamdulillah adult, and I know you still remember everything last few years back. If you remember last year in 2000, before last year 2019, when we were hearing the word, you know, coronavirus. If you remember in 2019 yourself, maybe perhaps you were in your foundations, or some of you maybe in your O level, no, sorry, maybe A level, you know, doing something. You know, when you were hearing in 2019, in middle of October, November, December, you don't even memorize the word coronavirus. You know, you now we know coronavirus, what it is, but that's that. That time, before 1.5 years, we didn't even care about it. We know that, you know, this coronavirus was there in Wuhan city in China, but we never, you know, gave any we never give any attention to it, because we thought it is that just a Chinese problem. There are many problems in China, and this is one of the problems. We didn't think that, you know, we will be affected this much. No one thought. So today we know the entire history of coronavirus. We know the entire history of COVID-19 pandemic and how it affected it, because we keep on hearing and hearing. Maybe for another next 100 years, I think nobody is going to forget the name coronavirus. See that? This is what actually is the world today. You know, if anything happened in one place, look how fast the things actually, you know, going and moving. So that's why we need to be aware of these kind of things, and we need to understand we cannot become the reason to another to happen, I mean, to another pandemic to happen. So that's why this kind of courses is for life. It's not for the profession. It's not for your job. It's not for your salary. This is actually for our life. Right? If I cannot make my surroundings safer, then how am I supposed to make the world a better place? So that kind of objectives, this is where we need to demonstrate this course. So through multiple case studies, students are expected to understand the challenges and barriers in integrating sustainable development and local, national, and international. Remember these things are local, national, and international. The next slide, again, this is demonstrate understanding the awareness of the different concept of sustainable development, because it's been the study right now, because this is actually still a recently developed study. This is not like, you know, computer engineering. This is not like a mechatronic engineering. This is not like architecture. This is not like a ICT. This is not like, you know, political science. This is not like human sciences. This is not like Arabic language. This is not like a Quran and Sunnah or Usuluddin or a fiqh, right? I think I almost covered all of your departments, if maybe some of them I missed. So this is not like a well-known, fundamentally established discipline. The sustainability discipline is actually just started going, just started coming out, just started people, every one of them actually looking into it. The way we understood, not necessarily sometimes, you know, even the president of the powerful country still didn't understand. You know, the powerful country president, he was saying that he doesn't believe in global warming. That kind of reaction. So now everybody understand it is a real, it is happening. In fact, you know, when there was a, this is my recent update, if you want to know. You know, just like I was actually counting the days, this just happened, I think, 1 week ago. Before 1 week, I was counting the days that there was no rain in especially in Gombak area, especially the area that where I live. You know, like my place that where I live is actually, it's actually Star Park, Danau Kota, Kuala Lumpur, that part, you know, the part close to Jalan Gombak, Medan Idaman, Danau Kota, you know, those places, including our university, Gombak. I've been noticing this last three continuously more than 3 to 4 weeks. I heard, sometimes there was a rain in Puchong, in Damansara area. I heard there was raining, but I've been counting this more than 3 weeks, 21 to 28 days. There was no rain. Can you believe that country like Malaysia, which is actually heaven, green and heaven, this country is heaven for everybody. The greenery, I think, of course, if you are coming from outside country, you will understand. Some of you, Mashallah, you said you are coming from Indonesia, some of you coming from Morocco, yeah, some of you coming from China. I think I don't have anyone, I think, from subcontinent. Anybody from Bangladesh, Pakistan, and India? I don't think. So we value, we understand what exactly rain, because in subcontinent, especially in African countries, I think you have also Morocco in the Middle East and all. I think you know the rain has a season. The rain only comes, in some countries, like in back in India, in my place is actually now it's actually November, December, there will be raining. That's all. You won't see raining all the whole year. But country like Malaysia, people always keep their umbrella all the time. And if you notice, if you are new to this country, you will be noticing that, wherever there is a bus stand, wherever there is a train station, there is always, roof. People, because they have to walk, because there is always raining. There is always raining. So people, they have to walk. They have to go all the way. So whether you have umbrella or not, still you can actually use the roof and you can walk all the way to the train station or the bus station where you actually go on. This is became your life. So this is just one example that I want to give you, which I actually encountered in recent time, like which before 1 week time. I was counting this because I saw that my neighborhood was full of mosquitoes. I didn't realize why all of a sudden there are full of mosquitoes. Then I realized that there is no water. When there is no rain, when there is no rain, the water become, stink, and then it stays and it become what, it's there all the time, stay stagnant. The water becomes stagnant, and then of course the mosquitoes is good place for the mosquitoes to leave their eggs, and then all of a sudden, everywhere I see mosquitoes. Just because of, why? Because there is no rain. If there is rain comes every day, it will wash away. I'm just giving you an example. We didn't realize this, but it can happen anytime. Most importantly, I used to go every day, like today I'm not able to go, but every day 6 to 7, I always go jogging and cycling and everything in my surrounding. But I noticed that the grass, everything become, become dry. I used to see green. Then I started seeing everything become gray. So I have been here more than 10 years, as I told you, but these are the things now I started identifying, I started looking. Then I realized that, there is something that actually happening. That the global warming is happening, or kind of, the ozone actually. Okay, I will be inshallah discussing with you when the right time comes. Most probably within few weeks, I think we are going to discuss the real factor, the real factors why there are global warming, and in fact we will be looking into scientifically we will be looking into the reasons why these things are happening and what we're supposed to do for social and environment, and how do we look into the perspective on economy. These are the things inshallah we will be looking into it. All right, so this is why actually we are doing this subject, collaboratively play the roles of member society to analyze challenges encountered by different societies in various development issues such as healthcare, education, social security, gaps between economic prosperity and environmental degradation. Environmental degradation, so remember that word is very important. Yeah, degradation, this is what actually happening. to work together as members, society, to develop alternative and creative solutions to address the issues of sustainable development on campus community. So this working together, it has to be our, you know, our nature, you know, because you know the collaboration is actually should be our nature. So now I'm very happy to see this thing happening inside the campus, because if we practice in our campus, definitely we go outside and then we will practice with the real society. If we don't practice here, if we don't mingle with each other, then how we are going to bring changes outside, right? So this is the great opportunity for all of us. We have internationals, we have locals, we have so many states in locals, and this is the only place where actually you can actually work together with other faculty members, and your lecturer also is not from your own faculty. So this is where actually we can actually forget about our differences and then think what is good for our sajahtara, our well-being. Yeah. And this course is actually giving you the responsibility to carry. It's not about, you know, winning or getting a good grades, getting a good CGPA in your degree. It is not about only those a degree. It is more than that. It's beyond that. How am I supposed to be a, you know, be a contribution to this particular safeguarding the universe, safeguarding the environment, socially and economically and politically? So the first year, first semester, this is what actually we are giving to you. This is how we actually welcome you. I know this is it's going to be a very difficult time. I know that, you know, you are supposed to be coming to the classroom and then see the classroom and see everybody face to face and then have that kind of, you know, one-to-one kind of face-to-face kind of collaboration. But I understand that thing is not happening right now, but of course very soon it's going to change the pattern of course. The pattern of education is not going to be remaining the same, inshallah. It will be soon, it will be different. But I can understand the most of you first year students or maybe second semester students, I understand that, you know, you have the dream to come to UIA and then this is what's happening. This is actually what actually happening to you. You are not able to enjoy the moment because you see that the reason I could have worked from home, but I came myself all the day. Every single day I just come to this campus because, you know, I can come and open my window. See, right now it is not only me talking, there is the nature also talking to you. You can see some birds or you know, the birds actually giving you a lecture. I can see the sky, I can see the masjid from here, the trees, even I'm just beside the river, you know, enjoying the nature. So that's the kind of thing. Hopefully, inshallah, you will be also getting it very soon. I'm looking forward to see you. You know, this is where actually we need to see to work together as member of society to develop alternative and creative solutions to address the issues of sustainable development on campus community. So, inshallah, right now it is an online campus community, but very soon, inshallah, it will be the physical campus community. All right, so okay, these are the assessment that which I actually told you earlier. I will be giving you this assessment during the slides. So this is where you need to know that your 15% will be like, you know, kind of online activities like quizzes or games or forum. Right, it could be MCQ questions. Don't worry, I'm not going to ask you any midterm or any final exam, writing exam. It's gonna be like, you know, most probably quizzes, inshallah, very simple MCQ quizzes, which actually covering the whole slides, you know, entirely. Then you have the written reflective journal. You know, I want you to, you know, get some reflection from your own, and then in your own world, you write around, maybe let's make it 3 blocks. So I give you 5 marks for each block. I will be, inshallah, giving you the date and everything, the instruction, how your reflective journal should be. It will be, inshallah, it will be given to you. So some classes are making like 5 blocks or 7 blocks. It's okay. Myself, I will just make it into 3 journal blocks. And then you can actually share it with us. You can share in Italian. I also will be looking into some good writing. So inshallah, maybe I can actually forward into our university, you know, university blog, or maybe university's letterhead. You know, anything, there are possibilities out there. Even we can actually send it to some newspapers. So everything is possible from here. So if you want to write well, if you want to write, if you are a good writer, or you want to become the good writer, this is actually the opportunity for you. Just start writing. Don't worry about grammar mistakes. Don't worry about your constructing the sentence. Don't worry about it, because no one here is actually English. Right? Are you English? Of course, you know English, but you are not English, right? Whether you are, I'm Indian, you are Malay, or you know, some other country. So not necessarily, we don't have to worry about the language. We will, inshallah, slowly learn. First of all, we learn from our own mistake. You send it to me, I will look into it, and if there is a problem, I will highlight it, and I will tell you, it is good to make mistakes so that you can learn those mistakes, and then you can do better. Right, then we have final paper individually. You have final paper, is like a term paper you need to submit before end of the semester, which is actually 20%. Yeah, so every one of you should take one topic. There are multiple, plenty of topics are available, so you can talk about water, you can talk about cloud, you can talk about tree, you can talk about, you know, so these are the things comes under final paper individual 20%. So you have 30 plus 20, 50 marks, which is actually based on your individual assessment. Then the remaining 50 marks will be the group sustainable development project. There will be a proposal of project. Then there will be a creative presentation of final project. This creative presentation, I would say, I will be looking into see the documentary kind of things. You know, if you, there are plenty of documentary available. I want you to resemble, I want you to, you know, make that kind of documentary. So hopefully, inshallah, your group can do that. Yeah, so all together you have 100 marks. Then okay, now let us start with the real course, especially the first week. What are the learning inputs? What are the things that we are going to cover in today's class? Is actually, we are going to talk about starting from system thinking. All right, then what is sustainable development? Because system thinking is something that without it, actually, you cannot see the sustainable development. So that's why system thinking is important. Then we talk about sustainable development. Then we talk about what exactly development, what are the things needed to be developed, to be sustained. Then we will find the balance, finding the balance between, I told you three things, remember, the triangle. Yeah, we have triangle, economy, social, and environmental. Then we have the fundamental principles of sustainable development. This is 5P, we call it. Yeah, remember 5P: people, planet, prosperity, peace, partnership. People, planet, prosperity, peace, partnership. Then we have international framework of sustainable development. So we are going to not learn everything today. We are going to see few things for today, and then we will stop. Then inshallah, we will continue the remaining thing for the next week. Yeah. So let us start with what is system thinking. All right. So to know what is system thinking, I want you to watch this video. I think it's already here. So can I just play the video, and then I'll ask you something after the video? Okay, please go ahead.
Systems thinking means understanding how systems are interconnected, as well as understanding the dynamics within systems. A system is a configuration of parts connected and joined together by a web of relationships or networks. Systems thinking is non-linear. This means that in systems, cause and effect are not necessarily linked or connected with simple step-by-step chains. Connections between human and natural systems are of particular interest because they offer excellent examples of cascading effects. Cascading effects means that what might seem to be a simple outcome of a given system can actually have a series of effects on other interconnected systems. Let's consider the following quick example of systems thinking. When looking at a hot dog, you might see a delicious ballpark fan favorite. However, have you ever considered how many miles, steps, or networks it takes to produce a hot dog with all your favorite toppings? Think about all the unique steps that are involved in producing just mustard. Mustard seeds come from India, and some of our favorite fancy mustards are prepared in France. Beyond the mustard seeds, mustards require turmeric, also made in India, and paprika from Hungary or the Netherlands. In addition, salt, water, and white vinegar are also needed. Considering the system that is involved in producing simply one condiment can be complex, let alone thinking about the entire process that is necessary to produce a fully loaded hot dog. People are not particularly well equipped for systems thinking. It's much easier to understand and interact with simple linear cause and effect chains. The more complex the system dynamics, the more difficult it is to know how decisions will play out. Oftentimes, decisions or actions at one point have an impact on another component within the system. For example, thinking about our ballpark hot dog, if mustard seed production is decreased by warmer weather patterns one year, then the price for this key ingredient is likely to rise. This in turn could limit production, making mustard seed more expensive and or not as readily available. Within systems thinking, it is important to see the interconnected nature of all the elements and to understand that reacting to a problem in one part of the system may have unintended consequences on other components or the process as a whole. Systems thinking does not claim complete knowledge. Rather, systems thinking is about assessing the degree of system complexity, analyzing system dynamics, and making decisions that reduce the risk of negative outcomes. To develop systems thinking, explore how things might change under different circumstances. Look at possible associations and connections beyond the information that is being presented. Consider conducting an institutional analysis, which includes a robust review of existing practices, mechanisms, and procedures currently in place. Share your findings with relevant stakeholders and discuss both hidden and visible flows. Seek possible explanations and relationships. Think more globally about how you are part of major economic, environmental, and social systems. Consider how these systems directly impact one another and how they influence the immediate systems you work within.
All right, so that was the system thinking. Yeah, system thinking is a new paradigm of analysis that encourages and enables us to understand complex and often hidden dynamics throughout our world. Because you see, when they talk to you, when they give you an example of hot dog, they didn't even talk about how they make hot dog. They talk about, you know, the sauce that we are using, right? So that particular sauce, you know, the way that they are making, the making of those sauce, particular sauce, it requires, you know, how many countries to come in, right? How many weather has to come in? How many kind of efforts has to come in? You know, there is a turmeric, there is a corn, there is a, you know, there are so many things, you know, related to that mustard sauce to create. So we love mustard, you know, because, you know, it looks fancy, it looks nice because of the color and everything, but it's not that expensive also, right? It's not that expensive. It comes to your hand, you know, at very low cost. That's because of the production. There is enough production so that the supply, there is enough supply to every single country. So it is not that difficult to get that mustard sauce because you go to any supermarket, it is easily available. So now you need to understand here that in order for you to get that mustard sauce or chili sauce or tomato sauce, the plenty of brains, plenty of human brains already worked hard to do that. So they keep that to you. So easily you just get down from your car, from your place, and then you just go to any shop, and then you can easily get it, and then you can easily use it, or you can throw it, or whatever you can do, you can do. You can buy and you can do whatever it is. But that production, they spent a lot of time thinking about the production. That's why any product, when it comes at the beginning, it is always expensive, right? So if you just to give you an example, you know, recently I was actually changing the digitalizer for the iPad. I think you know the digitalizer. Digitalizer is actually the screen, actually not the LCD, right? This is the phone. Let's say this is the iPad. There is an LCD, and on top, the one you are touching is called digitizer. This digitizer, when you are changing, I was checking, you know, some videos there were in YouTube, how to change it. Then I happened to see the video of 2011 in YouTube, and then he was mentioning this is how you change the digitizer, and the digitizer will cost around 150 US dollar. He said that the digitizer will cost 150 US dollar because you know that time the iPad, they were selling for 299 US dollar or 399 US dollar. So which means that the digitizer itself cost more than $100, which means that in Malaysia it's gonna cost you 400 ringgit. You know, just the digitizer. I'm talking about the digitizer, just the screen outside. Which I had actually for my son. It was actually a very old one, which was actually iPad 3. I don't know whether you still know that thing. iPad 3, not mini, the big one. So now, let me tell you what happened. When I was searching that digitizer online, and then I went to Shopee and Lazada, and I found that digitizer, and then I got it within one day, I think less than 24 hours, it reached my home, and then I myself was able to fix it. I fixed myself. Do you know how much it cost me? Just 24 ringgit. That digitizer cost me, it was actually this big size, 10 inch, cost me only 24 ringgit. In 2011, it cost more than 400 ringgit. So this is an example, I just want to give it to you. The way that when there are production comes and then the price goes down, you know, this is how. The point that I want to make here, why that 400 ringgit item became 24 ringgit, that's because of the human brain and the human effort to make into that affordable price. But the point that we are missing here, that how much resources has been wasted for that one particular glass of screen, or one particular screen to make. So now, if you want to know about that screen, I know you know that is a screen, but in order to make that one particular screen, do you know how many countries has to work for it? Do you know how many institutions, organizations have to work for it? And how many people has to come in? How many experts has to come in? And then you order, and then in less than 24 hours, it's reached you. It has reached you. So now, system thinking is something that, you know, when I look into a printer, I need to understand, is a printer. I know already it is a printer. I put paper inside, so it will bring something printed. But do I know how this printer has been made? What are the instruments inside? what are the things actually needed to have this, to make this. So now there are many, many people so far worked hard to create, to use the resources so that it, they make us to use in simple way, but not many people thinking how to minimize these efforts so that we can protect the environment. Petrol is 1 ringgit 70 cent, or maybe now it's 2 ringgit above. The price of the car become low because of the production. You know, we are thinking about buying the car and we are thinking about driving the car, but at the same time, you know, we actually causing the pollution. So now the most of us, people like us, work hard to get affordable, to create affordable car, but most of us not actually thinking how to minimize those pollution, how to minimize so that we can actually use the public transportation. You know, we, even though I have money, so I don't have to use the car, I don't have to buy the car. Even I have the car, I don't, you have to use all the time. You know, I can actually use the public transportation, or I minimize my using, you know. This is actually what these things require. These things require system thinking, right? This is what actually is a new paradigm of analysis that encourages and enables us to understand complex and often hidden dynamics throughout our world. Yeah. So now we also need systems approach. When there is a system thinking, we need a system approach, because now it's from climate change to coronavirus. They highlighted that complex adaptive system, right? All these things is actually key to handling the crisis. So it has been, you know, calling for more systemic ways of working, you know, for years. So this is what we need to go for, system thinking, and then we need to move into system approach, so that we actually can understand, you know, we can understand in the big picture. This is what actually required today, to understand everything, not as a consumer. We need to also understand as a producer, and also become responsible producer and responsible consumer. Because the responsible is not there. There are many consumers, there are many producers, but the responsible is not there. That's why we don't worry about cutting the tree. We don't worry about, because each and everything, the dress that I'm wearing, the shoe that I'm wearing, I'm having, you know, the glasses that I'm using, every single thing is actually so many resources has been destroyed for that purpose, and it become very cheap. That's what the true victory of the this is what actually the true achievement of the economy today, because they made it very affordable, and we are working hard for this. But at the same time, we are also destroying our environment. So that's why, you know, the sustainable development requires system approach based on system thinking. Yeah. So now coming back to these three diagram, the triangle that I always tell you, we need a viable natural environment, we need a social nurturing community, and we need a economic, which is actually sufficient economy. Yeah, these three things always remember, it is always interconnected. Yeah. Okay. This is the second question after system thinking. Now we need to understand what happened in current development. I think I gave you a few things already. The current development, if you actually want to know, you can actually think about the current development and with regard to environment, I want you to just think about it and then tell me what kind of serious environmental issues we have in Malaysia. Maybe some of you can just write down maybe 2-3 words also enough. Not necessary. You have to write like a paragraph. I think now it is available in your computer right now. Can you please answer my question? How serious is environmental issues in Malaysia? Just whatever you know. Yes. Go ahead. Write it down, please. Okay, in Malaysia, you don't know about Malaysia, Afandi. Okay, can you tell me about Indonesia? There are many environmental issues, right?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Can you write it down? There are many. Actually. Okay, those who knows about Malaysia, please go ahead. Anything is okay. Whatever you think. It doesn't have to be the right answers, yeah? Okay. Yes, very good. Deforestation, yes, is happening. Yeah, go ahead. Just one word. Okay, very good. Mining site waste, yes, correct. These things happening in Indonesia, right? So many, yeah. You know, the factories in Indonesia, there are so many foreign countries are opening their factories. Exactly. Water pollution. I think you know about water pollution in the river. Last time is the Sungai, yeah. Air pollution, yes, very good. Air pollution, yeah. Go ahead. There are many like that, yes, very good. Just to see you, very good to see you writing, yeah. Domestic waste system, yes, very good. Yes, correct. The food waste, you know, the recycling, we have problems in recycling. Even the collecting wastages also, we have problem in distributing the wastages. Maybe one more, okay. Biodiversity loss, yes, very good. That's a very good one, yeah. Any other thing, anything else? Illegal hunting, yes, is happening, yes, correct. Housing development, yes. Good. MashaAllah, many things are coming. Okay, good. That's good, you know. Okay, so if you have anything else, you can actually keep on in your in your writing, so you can let me know, inshallah. Yeah, you can also use it in your next term papers, next journal writing and everything. So this is what happening today, the environmental issues, fact and statistics. You can see the 63,000 square miles of rainforests are being destroyed each other. This is globally speaking. Every single day, you know, over 40% of all tropical forests have been destroyed and another acre is lost each second. Can you see that? The garbage in a landfill stays for approximately 30 years. People throwing it there for 30 years. Every ton of recycled office paper saves 380 gallons of oil. The US has less than 4% of its forest left. Everything gone. Only 4% of his forest left. You can see here also 500 hectares of forest destroyed every single day. Sorry, 50,000 hectares. Up to 100 species extinct. 60 million tons of carbon dioxide every day, you know, it's going to be, you know, this is becoming a pollution. It's going to bring the problem of gas, green gas house. So we have problem with, you know, unsustainable exploitation of resources. Like here, 40% of our global economy is depend on biologically derived products. This is the problem, biologically derived products, starting from petrol and everything. 17 million hectares of tropical forests destroyed each other. 70 to 100 species disappear. Water, soil, and air have been strained due to high pollution levels. You can see so many documentaries, you know, talking about all this. So you see, these are the few images I think you can see that the fish, you can see the problems, the urbanization, the rural areas. This is what we call the top 10 countries with the biggest ecological footprint per person. See, this ecological footprint, which means that, you know, one person is actually using more. They also used to call, the entire United States require more than two times of the entire world's resources. So now you can see here Qatar, one person in Qatar is actually using 11.68 footprint, ecological footprint, meaning to say that he is using that much ecological resources. So then you have less Kuwait, UAE, and look at it. The first three is actually Muslim countries. To whom should we go and complain? This is the Muslim countries. The first three top countries are Muslim countries. We are the leading, we are here leading the way. We are leading to the ecological footprint. The least, as you can see here, the least, Gabon, Mali, Chad, Tunisia, mostly in African countries, Egypt, yeah. And then, okay, this is about, we are going to talk about how fair is Malaysian economy. And we are going to talk about equality. Most probably we are going to talk about the economy, society, social issues, economic issues. We talked about environment, but we want to talk about economy, and then we go into social. So inshallah, I will be continuing from this. From our next class, yeah. So let me just stop recording so that if you have any questions, you can ask me.